Hello and welcome to my YouTube channel, Voca Vita English. Are you looking for an inspiration to be successful in life? Then read fables. Yes, have you underrated fables? What are fables according to you? Is it only meant for small kids? No, fable is going to show you the way to success. Although fable is a literary genre, a very short story that teaches a moral or a practical lesson about how to succeed in life, but is only going to give you a kickstart in changing your mindset overall. It started as an early form of storytelling and believed to have been originated in India. It features animals, plants, and forces of nature with human characteristics. It's a story told by word of mouth from generation to generation. A long time ago, people used fables to help them solve their problems. Isn't it amazing to know all these things about fables? Yes, so now we know that fables are not only meant for kids. Want to know some more interesting elements and go deeper into the world of fables? Let's explore the characteristics of fables. So here are the characteristics of fables. It's a brief story. Main characters are usually animals. One character usually has a bad trait that leads to his or her downfall. Usually, fables teach you a lesson. Sometimes fables can be funny. It is fiction. It did not really happen. So none of the fable stories are real in nature. Usually have no more than 2 or 3 characters. Yes. And last thing, it is written only to entertain the reader. It has no relevance, or it is not ever based on a true or real story. Now let's see the famous examples of fable. The Crow and the Jar, The Wolf and the House Dog, The Fox and the Crow, The Country Mouse and the City Mouse, The Maid and the Milk Pail. These are some famous examples of fables. Do you think that fables and fairy tales are the same? So let's mark out the difference between fables. What do we find in a fable? So we find that animals that act like people. Setting is usually outside. It has only 2 to 3 characters, and the main character is suffering with something or is having a weakness. There is always a villain or a person with bad trait. Person means here the animal character, and a hero. And finally, there is always a moral of the story. Yes, and that is your tip to success. Do you think that fables and fairy tales are the same? No. Fables and fairy tales both comes under the category of folklores or folk tales. Let's see the main differences between fable and fairy tale. Talking about the definition, fable focus mainly on giving an important moral lesson, whereas a fairy tale mainly focus on creating a fantasy world to the reader. If you talk about the style, fables can be in prose or poem, but fairy tales are always in prose. Talking about the nature, fables, there's no hidden meaning. It's meant to convey a moral truth. Whereas fairy tale creates a world of magic and leave much room for imagination and fantasy, leaves the reader fill gaps. Good and evil. Fable, there's no conflict between the good and evil. Whereas in fairy tale, there's always a conflict between the good and the evil. And let's talk about, finally, the characters of fable. Often the characters are animals, whereas the fairy tales are filled with fairies and their magical creatures in the magical worlds. Yes, it's all about fantasy when we talk about fairy tales. So a fairy tale, what do we find? We find magic, good versus evil, special beginning, once upon a time, something like that. Things come in 3s or 7s. Yes, so 3 or 7 characters maybe. Talking animals you'll find here also. Royalty, any king or queen story based. Special powers. You have all such characters to make fairy tale a really fantasy trip for all of you. So we know now that fairy tale and fable is not the same. Yes, we know the difference. Let's talk about the famous themes of fable. Be nice to others. Don't brag. Say nice things to others. Everyone is not perfect and we all need help sometimes. Don't be greedy. Working together gets a lot done. Be honest. Do the right thing even if it is hard to do. You should always work hard and get all of your work. So isn't these amazing fable themes, and doesn't it teach us so many things to get successful in life? Yes, so start reading fables and don't underrate fables as only kids copyright. Let's discuss some very common famous examples of fables. The Hare and the Tortoise, The Boy Who Cried Wolf. Very popular story. The Thirsty Crow, we all know about it. Yes, The Town Mouse and the Country Mouse is another famous example of a fable. The Fox and the Grapes. Yes, these all are fables. Now let us start with one of the famous fables, The Town Mouse and the Country Mouse, and see what all things we can learn from an ordinary fable. It's actually an interesting one. So let's start with the story. I've already circled the tough words for you so that you can enhance vocabulary. Yes, now let's start reading. Here's the first page coming on your screen. A town mouse once visited a relative who lived in the country. For lunch, the country mouse served wheat, stalks, roots and acorns with a dash of cold water for drink. The town mouse ate very sparingly, nibbling a little of this and a little of that, but by her manner making it very plain that she ate the simple food only to be polite. See the three words marked. So the three words are stalks, that means main stem of a plant. Acorns, that means the fruit of oak tree. And sparingly, that means taken in a restricted manner or in very small quantity. So till here we have understood the town mouse visited a relative who lived in a country. For lunch, the country mouse served wheat, stalks, roots and acorns with a dish of cold water for drink. All this was served to him. The town mouse ate very sparingly, nibbling a little of this and little of that. Nibbling means taking short bites, sparingly in a restricted manner, taking very small quantities and was biting very slowly and taking small quantities in. And by her manner, making it very plain that she ate the simple food only to be polite. Yes, so she was showing that she used to eat very simple food and that also showing that she was very polite. Let's come to the next page. So after the meal, what happened? The friends had a long talk, or rather, the town mouse talked about her life in the city while the country mouse listened. They then went to bed in a cozy nest. Cozy means comfortable nest in the hedgerow. Hedgerow is what? Hedgerow is a net of shrubs bordering a road or a field. You've seen the borders made by shrubs, that is a hedgerow. And slept in quiet and comfort until morning in her sleep. The country mouse dreamt she was a town mouse with all the luxuries and delights of the city. So this is the dream that we are talking, that her friend had described for her. So the next day, when the town mouse asked the country mouse to go home with her to the city, she gladly said yes. She was waiting for that. When they reached the mansion in which the town mouse lived, they found on the table in the dining room the leavings of a very fine banquet. What is a banquet? An elaborate or formal evening meal that was served on the table. There were sweetmeats and jellies, pastries, delicious cheeses, indeed, the most tempting food a mouse can imagine. But just as the country mouse was about to nibble a dainty piece of pastry, take small bites off a small bit of pastry, she heard a cat mew loudly and scratch at the door. In great fear, the mice scurried to a hiding place. Scurried means run hurriedly. When they lay quite still for a long time, hardly daring to breathe. When at last they ventured back to the feast. Ventured is an action that you are doing out of risk. So they came back to the table taking a lot of risk. The door opened suddenly and in came the servants to clear the table, followed by the house dog. The house dog was also there along with the servants to clear the table. Now let's have a look at the words that we have learned. Hedgerow, banquet, scurried and ventured. Four new words added to your dictionary. See the next page. The country mouse stopped in the town mouse's den only long enough to pick up a carpet bag and umbrella. You may have luxuries and dainties that I have not, she said as she hurried away. But I prefer my plain food and simple life in the country with the peace and security that go with it. Dainties means something very good to eat, delicacy maybe. So she said that you might have everything, but you have no security. At the last, we see that the moral of the story or the lesson is, poverty with security is better than plenty in the midst of fear and uncertainty. Midst means in the middle part or middle point. So we see that we have learned from this page two new words, dainties and myths. So many new words we have added to our dictionary. And you have always underestimated the power of fables when they have so much in store for you. So start reading fables, be motivated for being a better human being, and don't forget to write me in the comments about your favorite fable. If you like the video, please like, share and subscribe my channel, and I'll come back to you every Wednesday and Saturday with a new and informative video. Till then, happy learning!